सो जो एडवांस डिजाइनर्स होते हैं वो टूल्स यूज करते हैं सुपरनोवा स्टूडियो जैसे, जिससे वो क्या करते हैं अपनी डिजाइन को एक रॉ लेवल कोड में कन्वर्ट करते हैं, जिससे कंपोनेंट्स, अलाइनमेंट्स, मोबाइल फोन के मल्टीपल अलाइनमेंट्स सेट करते हैं, ठीक है, ताकि उनके जितने भी ये विजुअल कंपोनेंट्स हों वो ऑटो एडजस्ट हो जाएं विद डिफरेंट मोबाइल साइजेस, विद डिफरेंट मोबाइल फोन्स, ओके? सो हाउ डू वी डू इट? आई टेक यू टू दैट. बिफोर आई टेक यू दैट, लेट मी जस्ट रीनेम द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द वीडियो. सो दिस इज इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ डिजाइन लॉगिन पेज फॉर प्रैक्टो पार्ट वन. ओके नाउ सो आई एम टेकिंग यू टू स्टेप नंबर टू. नाउ हियर वी विल As an advanced designer, you don't need to do the step. For you, the Adobe XD file is enough to get started with the code. I'll walk you through with each code. But as an advanced designer, I would like to show you the strategy. Okay. So once you get Mac, then you can follow the same strategy to get your applications done in a very shorter span of time. Okay. Moreover, so this is the first page. Now similarly, you can have n number of pages in your application design, and then you can give it to the developer so as to get it coded. Okay. So I delete the Practo's image. I think this is not required for us now, and this becomes our first page. And I'm going to change, rename this to as login. Page. This becomes my login page. So this becomes my first page of the application. Now I can have n number of pages designed. Okay. So that we have a complete flow available that how many pages we would be having in our application. Fine.
Okay.
So now sometimes happens, let's say there are 5 applications of healthcare available. You want X component from one app, Y component from other app. So you can take references from all those apps, combine all those pages into your Adobe XD, and then either give it to the developer or the coder to get your thing done. Okay. So this is how, this is the standard strategy of building an advanced level application. Okay. Now, so what we'll do, we'll get into the next step now. In order to get into the next step, I am taking you to Supernova Studio.
Okay.
This step you don't need to do. I'll walk you through from building the code, how it's going to be done. And one more thing, let me just quickly save it. So I'm going to save this file as local document, and I'm going to rename it as, from Vinit, I'll change it to Practo Day 2. Adobe code. Okay. And I'll upload it on your card.
Okay.
Practo Day 2 Adobe code. So now you'll have this Adobe file available. The Supernova Studio, which I'm training you currently, would be shortly available for Windows users also. Okay. I'll walk you through with what it is. So there's a tool known as Supernova Studio for designers who are not coders, Okay. So what it is, this is a realization of the full potential of the design systems, where what people can do, they can design and code together. You can design the applications, you can configure them and code it at the same time. Okay. So there are a lot of features available with Supernova, which we will be using. Okay. And you can actually request early access for the Windows users. Okay, that's going to be available soon. Now, so I'm taking you to that tool. So now I will start Supernova Studio. Within Supernova Studio, what we can currently do, we can import sketch or XD files. Okay, so we have an XD file available. So I'm going to import it. So in order to import it, what I need, I want to import Practo Day 2 Adobe code. This is what we built. I've clicked on open. And you can see that I can actually get started the code now for Flutter, for iOS, for Android, or for React. These are the top frameworks available for front-end designs and the back-end connectivity. Okay. So I'll currently build it for Android. Okay. Now the name of the project will be, let's say, Practo Prototype, or we need Android app, any of those we can take. So let's say I can also take Vineet Android app, or to name it easy, I can call it as Vineet app. Let's say. So you can name your project accordingly. Project styles would be, we'll use a design tokens, not a problem. We're going to select this page. So it might be possible that in your Adobe file, you would have designed 10 pages, and out of which, if you want to select only a few, you have that facility to select a few, or you can also select all. Okay, so currently we only have one page, login page, which we created. So I'm going to select the login page and I'm going to import it. So once I import, now you can see I've got that Adobe page opened here. Mm-hmm. And it looks exactly the way we designed. Right? Okay. And the best part is on the right hand side, you can see that you're getting a sample relevant code built for it also. The basic login page activity is also available. Okay? But we'll start it from the scratch. You don't need to worry about it. Okay.
अच्छा इसमें मतलब ये जो हमने डिजाइन बना है इसका सारा कोडिंग इसने ऑटोमेटिकली जनरेट करके दी है ना?
ऑटोमेटिकली जनरेट कर दिया.
ओके okay, और अगर डिजाइन भी हम इसी में करते हैं सुपरनोवा स्टूडियो में ही मतलब यही से शुरू करते हैं तो ये साथ के साथ इसको कोड करता रहता ये कह रहे थे आप
नहीं सुपरनोवा स्टूडियो में आप अभी करेंटली डिजाइन कर नहीं सकते हैं सिर्फ डिजाइन को एडिट कर सकते हैं
ओके ओके
तो इनिशियली डिजाइन हमें अडोबी
एक्सडी पे ही करना
okay. करना पड़ेगा
ठीक है
यहां पे हम इन डिजाइन को एडिट कर सकते हैं जैसे आप
ओके ओके
चाहते हैं कि कलर हमने चेंज कर दिया तो फिर हमारे कोड में भी कलर चेंज हो जाएगा
ठीक है
लाइक दैट ओके और यहां से हम कोड मॉडिफाई भी कर सकते हैं सो नाउ यू सी द बेस्ट पार्ट इज वी गॉट अ बेसिक प्रोटोटाइप कोड क्रिएटेड लेट्स से अ लॉगिन पेज एक्टिविटी डॉट जावा इज क्रिएटेड बट लेट्स से इफ यू वांट टू चेंज इट टू कॉटलिन वी विल चेंज इट टू कॉटलिन आल्सो ओके सो वी हैव द फैसिलिटी अवेलेबल सो करेंटली एट द टॉप यू कैन सी एट द वेरी टॉप करंट लैंग्वेज इज जावा But I'll change it to Kotlin. So once I change it to Kotlin, it becomes a KT file, a Kotlin file. Kotlin is very similar to Java. Okay. There is no much difference. Only how we access the scope, how we call the variables is different. So this becomes login page activity.kt, a Kotlin file. Name of the application is Vineet app. Currently, this is created by Devanshu Shukla, copyright at Hackweda, which I can modify as per my choice. Okay. Then there are a few basic packages which will be loaded. This is the class login page activity. We'll work out on it. I'll walk you through with the basics of backend code. But currently, my objective is to show you how we can make a design and convert it into a relevant component of Android. Okay. So this becomes an easy process because this is the hardest part. 99% of people, why they cannot become good developers, because they don't know the strategy that they have to design first and then convert it into beautiful components. So now you can make any of the applications similar to Google, Uber, XYZ, okay, Zomato, any of that. Now, बट स्टिल इट रिक्वायर्स अ लॉट ऑफ बैक एंड कोड. ठीक है, बहुत सारा बैक एंड कोड की जरूरत पड़ती है, बट ठीक है, विल सी हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू मेक इट. सो अब अगर आप करंटली देखोगे तो हमारे पास ये स्क्रीन है एंड आई विल टेक यू टू द डिजाइन व्यू. अभी मैंने टॉगल किया है डिजाइन व्यू. ठीक है, कोड से मैं डिजाइन व्यू पे आ गया. अभी आप थोड़ा सा देखोगे कि हमारे दो सेक्शंस थे. सेक्शन वन तो प्रॉपरली दिख रहा है क्योंकि हमने प्रॉपरली अलाइन किया था, अरेंज किया था. सेक्शन टू थोड़ा सा ऊपर खिसक गया है. ठीक है, तो ये अभी हमें कॉन्फ़िगरेशंस करनी पड़ेंगी.
ओके,
तो वी विल डू दिस कॉन्फ़िगरेशन हियर. सो नाउ व्हाट आई डू, आई क्विकली शिफ्ट टू कंपोनेंट्स हियर. ओके, जो हमने Adobe XD में कंपोनेंट्स बनाए थे, अब आपको वो कंपोनेंट्स यहाँ पे दिखाई देंगे. वी हैव गॉट अ सेक्शन टू, वी हैव गॉट अ सेक्शन वन. दो सेक्शंस हैं हमारे पास. सेक्शन वन को उठा करके मैंने ऊपर कर दिया सबसे पहली बार. ठीक है, तो अब अगर आप ये देखोगे सेक्शन टू है लेकिन एक्चुअली थोड़ा सा ऊपर शिफ्ट हो गया है. हम अलाइनमेंट करेंगे अभी प्रॉपरली. ठीक है, दिस इज माय सेक्शन वन. अब अलाइनमेंट्स अगर आप देखोगे तो ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड, ठीक है, ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड इनफैक्ट, यहाँ पे सारा का सारा पूरा कॉन्फ़िगरेशन अवेलेबल है. द कॉन्फ़िगरेशन फॉर बिहेवियर, द अलाइनमेंट्स, हाउ वी हैव टू मेंटेन एवरीथिंग. Is that clear? So, अभी मैंने सेक्शन वन सेलेक्ट किया. सेक्शन वन मेरे को वैसे सब बढ़िया लग रहा है, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं लग रही है ना, प्रॉपरली है. तो बस मुझे एक चीज कन्वर्ट करनी पड़ेगी. सेक्शन वन के अंदर एक मेरा ऐप हेडलाइन है जिसको मैं ऊपर कर देता हूँ. ऐप हेडलाइन तो मेरा ठीक है. फिर मेरा स्लाइड व्यू है, स्लाइड व्यू. ओके, स्लाइड व्यू को मैं एक्चुअली स्लाइडर बनाना चाहता हूँ. आई वॉन्ट टू मेक इट एज अ हॉरिजॉन्टल slider. So I'll right click and I'll convert it into a component.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, what would be the component? These are the following kind of components which are available in Android. We have a scrolling view, we have a stacking view, we have a blurring view, we have text views, we have buttons, we have image views, we have editable text, we have recycler views, we have grid recycler views. Okay. So the one which we do need to do is a recycler view. Or a grid recycler view, okay? But currently we don't have a grid, so we'll take a horizontal recycler view, okay? So if I click here, recycler view, okay? So abhi recycler view, yahan pe mereko isko thodi si uski properties change karni padengi from here, so that it becomes a proper recycler view. So I'll not shuffle the component, wo main abhi ek bar अरेंज करता हूँ प्रॉपरली कि हाउ मेनी शेडोज वुड बी देयर एंड हाउ मेनी थिंग्स वुड बी देयर. ठीक है, अभी मैं इसको यहीं पे ले आया हूँ. सबसे पहले मैं सेक्शन वन और टू को थोड़ा सा अरेंज पहले प्रॉपरली कर लूँ, फिर हम इसको ठीक करते हैं. तो अगर मैं सेक्शन टू को भी क्लिक किया तो आप देखोगे ये मेरा जो बॉटम ये पिंक दिख रहा है आपको, तो वो फिक्स हो गया इस लोकेशन पे, इस वजह से वो प्रॉब्लम कर रहा है. तो अगर आप यहाँ पे राइट हैंड साइड पे देखोगे तो बिहेवियर में मेरा ये एज इनेबल्ड है. सो अब क्या हुआ कि वो कंपोनेंट उस पोजीशन पे फिक्स हो गया है, इसलिए ऊपर को खिसक रहा है. तो व्हाट आई वांट इज मैं इसको अनक्लिक कर देता हूँ. ठीक है, आई डोंट वांट इट. ठीक है, जब मैंने इसको हटा दिया तो अब ऑटोमेटिकली सेक्शन वन के नीचे सेक्शन टू आ जाएगा. ओके, मैं सेक्शन टू को फिक्स कर सकता हूँ कि सेक्शन टू की लोकेशन यही रहे, सेक्शन टू के टॉप को. हम चारों साइड से भी फिक्स कर सकते हैं कि तीनों साइड से फिक्स होना चाहिए. पता, बॉटम तो हटा देते हैं, तो लेफ्ट से, राइट से और टॉप से इसी पोजीशन पे अलाइंड रहेगा डिपेंडिंग ऑन द स्टैंडर्ड. अब कोई भी अगर एप्लीकेशन किसी भी मोबाइल फोन पे आप खोलोगे तो टॉप से उतनी दूर पे होगा, लेफ्ट से उतनी दूर पे होगा, राइट से उतनी दूर पे होगा, ऑटोमेटिकली एडजस्ट हो जाएगा. छोटा फोन होगा तो छोटा हो जाएगा, बड़ा फोन होगा तो बड़ा हो जाएगा. बट अभी आप देखेंगे तो प्रॉपर दिख रही है आपको एप्लीकेशन. ठीक है, सेकेंड पार्ट क्या है, अब मुझे एक कॉम्पोनेंट सेक्शन टू में चेंज करना है जो कि मेरा टेक्स्ट बॉक्स है. ठीक है, ये टेक्स्ट बॉक्स को एक्चुअली मैं रीनेम करना चाहता हूँ एंड आई विल रीनेम इट टू एडिट टेक्स्ट. बट चलो टेक्स्ट बॉक्स भी है तो कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. विल क्विकली कन्वर्ट इट इनटू अ कंपोनेंट and I want to convert it into an editable text. Okay, so editable text as in we will be able to write some data in it currently. Okay, now you can see that the font is not looking good currently because it looks very small. It is attached at the very top. So we are going to modify this behavior. To modify this, we'll go to the right hand side for this edit text property. The content type is single line. What kind of keyboard you want? Do you want a number pad? Since it was a mobile number, we can take it as a phone pad.
Okay.
Okay. If it's an email, you can take it as an email. So relevant keyboard automatically will open with at the rate and all that symbols. Okay. Similarly, if you're using URL, you'll automatically get HTTP colon double slash and all that stuff. So I'm going to take it as a phone pad. Okay. A phone pad. I'm going to convert it as a phone pad, which will eventually show me different kinds of numbers when we click on it. Okay. On the real mobile. Return key would be nothing, let's say. If you want to have a clear button, we can set a clear button. So at the right, it becomes somewhat like this. If you click on this cross, the number will automatically be removed. You don't need to press back again. Okay. If it would be a password, you can use it as secured. So automatically, whatever data you will be typing, it will automatically come in dots. But since it's not a password, so I'm not going to keep it secure. If it would be something like text or something, a paragraph where you want an autocorrect to be used, you can keep an autocorrect enabled. Now, from the top, where do you want it to be visible? Okay. So from the top, I want it to be 10 pixels below. Now, if I type, this will be 10 pixels below. Okay. I want to keep it more centered. I can take it as 12 below. Okay. From the left, how much distance you want to keep? I want to keep it 10 at least. The content should be have a padding of 10 from the left.
Okay.
Now, if I want it to be more center, I can put the value somewhere from here. So if I put 15, it now comes at a center. From the bottom and from the right also, you can put an inset. So from right also, I would like to keep the same inset of 10. So that if I have a larger content somehow, it shouldn't cross the screen. It should become hidden after that 10 facility, 10 pixels facility. But as you can see, I have a cross button here. So what I really want is, since I have a cross button here, I want it to be 20, let's say. From the right inside, it should be 20. So now you can see that it will not overfall on the X. Got it?
Got it.
Now, then we can define the placeholder text that what should be written over here. So we'll say enter mobile number. So we are going to get a placeholder. So once we click, it will automatically be removed. This is a placeholder text. Okay. Then we can use the font size. What should be the size? So you can click on AA and you can modify it. So since we were using Roboto as a standard font, so we can quickly use Roboto only. So as to maintain the, what do we call it as? Similarity. So as to maintain the similarity, MNOPQR. I'm going to use Roboto as the content. It should be a regular content, but size should be, let's say 24 or let's say 18 or 14 as per our choice. So 14 looks good to me. Okay. So the size is 14 and done. So I've got my configurations done. So now what I'll do, if I type it, I'll get a number somewhat like this. Okay. And if I click on cross, it will automatically be cleared and the enter mobile number be visible. Followed by, I've got another component, which should be acting as a button, trouble signing in. When I click on it, I should get to the sign in page. Okay. So what I'll do is I'll select this trouble signing in. This is the signing text view. We'll right click on it and convert this component to button control. Okay. So I've clicked on button. And now this becomes a button property. Okay. Got it. So now you can click on this. This is a clickable button. Okay. When you click on it, something will happen. Okay. So I think this is clear to you that we got proper design ready for the component. So we got the first page, we got some content, we got a button content ready. Okay. If I click here, I'll get out of this application. I'll quickly check if I can do that here. Now currently it's running over here, but once we'll run it on a mobile phone or a simulator, it will run properly. So we got the first design ready for our healthcare app. Got it? So since currently you don't have Android Studio, you currently don't have a design studio. So what I'll do is I'll export the code from here so that we'll continue in the Android Studio from here. Okay. For this page. And I'll show you how the component will be treated in the code view. So once we go here now, if you see, if I click on any of the component, so now we got a lot of different components, as in we got a sign in button, okay, where we got a set on click listener set up on it. Once we click on it, sign in will be done. Okay. Then on create, we got a content view. Okay. There are a few different files which has already been created, which I will be showing you once we get into it. There are certain XML files which you will see. Okay. The Kotlin code. So now what the part is, I've got this done. And this looks good to me. The design also looks good to me. Okay. I can even change the mobile phones and I can test it on different devices. Let's say if I want to test it on Galaxy Note 10. So it looks somewhat like this on Galaxy Note 10. If I want to see how it looks on Galaxy S10 Plus, it looks somewhat like this on Galaxy S10 Plus. So on different mobile phones, the application is going to look beautiful. Okay, got it?
Yes.
Right? So I believe we are clear till here. Great. So from here, now what am I going to do? I'm going to convert it into the basic code with the UI components ready, given to the developer so that now he can start coding at the back end. That once we take the mobile number, we'll send it to the server, authentication will be done, OTP will come. All that part will now be done in the code side. Okay. So how do we do it? This part, front-end designer will give to the back-end designer now. So I'm going to go to file and I'm going to export it to an Android project now, the basic design project in Android format. So I'll click on export to Android. I'll export anyway. Okay. In case if we are missing some fonts, we can go to fix fonts and we can say this PT Mono Bold is not available, so not a problem. We'll see. It will be replaced with some standard font. Won't be a problem. Okay. So I'll go file. I'll export to Android. I'll click on export anyway. Ignore the fonts. I don't worry about the fonts. So now we are exporting the complete project. Okay. So now project name will be Vineet App. Export project name will be Vineet App. Package name. So package name is very important. This is a unique identifier of your application. Okay. So the naming convention is company name, developer name, and the project name. So project name is Vineet App. So once you will be coding your applications, you will write your company name dot your name dot your application name. This is the naming convention. Now, for which Android SDK version do you want to export? The minimum SDK version. Okay. So we'll see which standard version we have. So I'll take it, let's say for SDK V24, I'm currently taking. Who's the author of the application? Let's say name of the developer, company name Hackweather. Allowed devices, do you want to allow it on tablets also? You can do it. Otherwise, we can keep it to phones only. So we'll select phones. Allowed orientation, portrait, landscape, however have you designed, you can do it. So we'll select it for portrait. Language settings, in which language would you want to export? So I want to export it in Kotlin language. Okay. So if you know Java, you can continue editing in Java. If you know Kotlin, you will continue editing in Kotlin. So we'll learn the fundamentals of Kotlin and then we'll get into it. Okay. Followed by user interface will be XML. Okay. Extensible. Architecture will be model view controller. This is the standard design pattern which is followed. And all the resources, the images which we have used, they will be generated for all the device types. So now, which means we have taken one image, but now once we export, it will be automatically the designs will be converted to different mobile versions of extra high density pixel, normal medium density pixel. It will be exported for all. Okay. Once I click on export, now I'm going to go to my download section and I'm going to export the project. Okay. Once I click on export, so now you can see that my project is ready now. The first Android project with the name Vineet app. So this is the basic files of Android, which is now ready. This we are going to open in Android Studio now and start modifying the application. So the front-end designer has done this part and given it to the back-end Android designer who knows Kotlin. Okay, now what we do? So we got this Vineet app project. Now we'll open Android Studio. It might be possible there might be certain changes, modifications which we need to do in the studio depending on the design export. So we do it in case if it's not an exact one, we'll modify it. Okay. So what we do? Now we are going to open a project. Okay, so we'll say open an existing Android Studio project. Okay, clicked on it, open an existing, and where is my project? In the downloads, I've got a new project, which is my Vineet app. That is my project, which I want to open. Okay, which we have currently built. I'm going to click on open. And now all the files with respect to Vineet app would now be opened in Android Studio. So here's the Vineet app. I've got the different structures like the app code where I have got the source files, where I've got the Kotlin files, okay, for Vineet app, where I have an adapter, I have an activity. With an activity, we have a login page activity. So we got it. This is the Kotlin file. Okay, the basic functionality is ready. Followed by, we've got the resources also, where in the layouts, I've got the login page activity. If I double click on it, so I'm going to get the visualized view of the application. Okay, this which we created. So now there will be certain things which we will need to configure, as in the trouble signing in has got a little size increased. So we are going to modify it. Okay, just we need to change the size of it, or we can extend it. Sorry. So we can either reduce the size. So here again, we'll have the dimensions which we can modify, reduce, and run. So now if I go here to the application, currently I'll go to login page activity. Currently there are no devices, so we can run it on a simulator. Okay, so I'll quickly click on run. It will ask me, there is no target device found. We do need to have a target device created. So I'm going to open AVD manager. With AVD, we can create a virtual device to test our apps. Okay. So you have to install Android Studio and you have to create a virtual device. Okay. So we can select a virtual device of our choice. Okay. Of a specific size. So we can use Samsung One or anything. So let's say this is a standard one which we'll be using, Pixel 2. So I'll go next. API level 30 is here. This the latest one. Okay. A system image must be selected to continue. So we can select a proper system image, let's say for version 4, whatever we want to do, we have to download all of these. So since we exported for 24, so I'm going to download it for 24. If you want to export it for 30, you can do it, select it from there, and then you can download the API 30 for the latest version. So if I will build for Nougat, it will be supported by all the other above APIs. Okay. But the new features will not be available. And even if I build it for 30, all the phones will be supported. Okay. So I quickly download this one. So this download might take some time, as in it's of 775 MB. So let the download complete for time being. By the time this download is happening, what I'll do is I'll upload the project code on the board. Android Studio port. What I'll do is, let me just quickly archive it. I'm going to compress it into a zip beneath app.zip. And I'm loading the zip code here. Okay. So now we have got our zip code ready as well. And we got approximately 94% of download has also been done. Now we have got API 24 version downloaded. We'll click on next. It's asking for a AVD name. So we'll say Pixel 2 API 24, that is the device which we are creating with Nougat version. So we'll click on finish. So we got the virtual device ready now. Okay. So what we'll do now, since the virtual device is ready and it is selected over here, Pixel 2 API 24, I click on play. So now our project is going to be built, and which we really observe at the very bottom. You can see that executing tasks, assembling, building the project beneath app. And now it is going to be launched here in the emulator. You can see that an emulator will now run while. And we got this emulator running here. So an Android emulator is starting. And within this Android emulator, we'll be able to see the application. This we can directly run on a mobile phone also. So once our Android mobile phone is connected with Android Studio, which we'll see how it is done, we are going to get our app running as well. So now you can see that now our app is running on the Android Studio. So this part, trouble signing in, this we will change in the layout, which we are already seen. And we got this. So we can get started with writing the number 9897-99066. Or if I click on it, so it is, it will give me that phone pad so that I can put 9654825370 and done. Got? So we got the first page ready. Rest will continue it from here in the next session.
Okay.
Have a great day. So now what do you have to do? You have to open the project. You have to set up Android Studio. You have to open the project in Android Studio, create a virtual device, and run the app on the virtual device and ensure that things are ready. And also you have to complete the design on Adobe XD also. Proper design, section-wise renaming, because that is very important. If you will not do that properly by arranging the sections, grouping it, when you will be exporting it to Studio, you will not get it in the proper alignment. Okay. So we need to make the proper sections so that everything is aligned properly and we can run it nicely. Got it?
Yes.
Have a great day. Okay. Understood, right? Everything is clear?
हाँ जी बिल्कुल.
थोड़ा कॉन्फिडेंस आ रहा है कि बना पाएंगे अब आप कोई बेहतर एप्लीकेशन?
अभी देखते हैं सर, ये ट्राई करने के बाद पता लगेगा.
राइट राइट, श्योर श्योर. ठीक है, हैव अ ग्रेट डे.
ओके ओके, थैंक यू सर.